Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. And isn't it a lovely day? Last night I couldn't sleep at all. Could you? I was tossing, turning. Oh, hot, sweaty female next to me. I had to get up and go home. Oh, anyway, let's just go on about it. This weather, I think it's quite nice. Mind you, I lived in Dubai. Do you remember I said I wanted to be an ethnic minority in someone else's country? Anyway, I'm back now. And I'm not doing the next line. Anyway, and so now this is quite a cool day from Dubai. It's Tuesday today. I've got to go into London in a minute after doing this to have lunch with the accountants about Ustream and investment, etc., etc., etc. It's boring. So I'm going to go in nice casual. He'll probably be in a suit and tie in the restaurant and I'll turn up looking like an aging old hippie from Miami Vice. But have you noticed that everyone is an expert about weather, aren't they?
Scarlet Willie, you're the expert. What's the weather going to be like tonight?
Oh, it'll be dark.
Excellent.
Yes, it has been quite hot. And so what have we got to put up with? If we're outside, we're going to get sunburn and skin cancer and God knows what. And the boffins, of course, are telling us 10,000 people will die. There was someone on the wireless this morning saying to this medical person, so you expected 10,000 phone calls yesterday about the heat. And he went, what are these people scaremongering, for heaven's sake? It's hot. Stay in the shade. Drink lots of water or beer or whatever. I don't know if beer is the best thing, but keep hydrated. Keep in the shade. And if you get sunburnt, put calamine lotion on it. So you go home looking like a strawberry and vanilla ice cream dish. You look all right. Calamine lotion. Remember that stuff? My old father-in-law, who I went to see this morning, old Melv, He had the bad tummy one night and he had the milk of magnesia by the bed but he couldn't find it. So he went down in the dark to the kitchen, to the remedy cupboard, and he opened it up and he drank a bottle of calamine lotion and had to go to hospital. Do you know, I've done this once. You see this tattoo here? That tattoo look, panther's head amongst the freckles. 10 bob from Woolwich, and the man said to me, if it swells up in the night and hurts, ask your mum. I said, no, I can't tell my mum, she'll kill me. He said, well, get some Vaseline and put it on it. Now, next to the sink where my dad used to wash and pee, there was a cupboard up there and a cupboard up there with the sliding things, like a washboard thing, cardboard almost. Chipboard, he'd open that and there'd be all the remedies in there. So in the night I went down like that with the light off and I grabbed the familiar jar, I put it on like that. Oh no, it was only Vic, that's all. Dear oh dear oh dear oh dear. And of course there's another story like that, isn't there, about the man that had the condom next to the bed. He didn't want to put it on because they're a bit embarrassing, condoms, aren't they? If you put one on and you stand up and it rolls down like a football sock, it's not the condom that is too big, it's your... Anyway, so he's put it by the size of the bed because condoms, they come in all shapes and sizes. I remember once I told my mate, he said, I got a luminous condom, showed it to the wife. She said, put it on in the dark and I'll leap in naked and land on it. I said, I bet that was a laugh. He said, yeah, it certainly was. I put it on the bedpost. Anyway, there's loads of those jokes, isn't there? There's loads of flavoured condoms, strawberry, lovely. And the wife said, oh, cheese and onion. Oh, I ain't got one on. Anyway, so he's put it by the side of the bed. Don't normally get jokes on YouTube, do you? But there you go. This is what you're missing out. This is a little insight into Ustream. Side of the bed. And at the moment, he said, he reached out and he found the familiar packet. Reached in, took out the innards of the packet, and with thumb and forefinger, as per instructions, slid it over the winkle. And she put the light on, and there he was, with an after-eight mint on the end of his dick. Anyway, let's just talk about, quickly, before we go over to Ustream and mention it, a little bit about the Conservative Party thing. Now, today, one of them's going to be voted out. I hope it is Liz Truss. I can't bear Liz Truss. Don't we? I like Kenny Banankanot. I like her, the Nigerian girl. I think she'd be really, really good. And of course, we all like Rishi. There you go. Who says the Conservative Party isn't diverse? Well, it certainly is diverse. But anyway, why don't we get a vote? They all stood there on the television like, you know, they're telling us all what they're going to do. They've stopped all that now. It was fucking cringy, wasn't it? Hello, I'm Rishi. Hello, I'm Liz. I'm Diane Abbott, and I shouldn't even be here. Anyway, so they've stopped all that. So I've got another idea. They should actually fight to the death for it, the last two. Rather like this. Yeah, great. I enjoyed doing that. And you'll be seeing it soon. Okay, quick look down my notes, what we've got to talk about. Nothing, really. So what I'm going to do now, we're going to go over to Ustream, and I'm going to talk about someone who's accused Sesame Street of being racist. You couldn't make it up. We're going to Ustream right after these commercials.
Ooh, what is it?
Coming soon on Ustream. Check it out. It's Boobs in the Wood.